Right, to begin the experiment, you need to set up your equipment. What we have is a distillation kit hooked up to a thermometer to realize when the water is boiling. The vapor from the water is then forced through the canal and into the Graham condenser, where it goes through a coil and is cooled down by the water around it, turning it back from vapor to water. The water is then collected in the beaker under the Graham condenser. To begin with, we must take some measurements of the water. In this case, we have chosen the pH value. To do this, we have hooked up the pH probe to the computer. Now we will know what the pH of this water is. The closer to 7, the more neutral and safer to drink it is. Now that we have our data on the water, we can ignite the gas with the sparker to get rid of bacteria like these, which could possibly be hazardous to drink. Using a Bunsen burner, the water from the river is heated until it reaches a temperature of around 100 degrees Celsius, at which time it is already boiling. The H2O molecules evaporate from the solution and are forced across through the glass tube, where they begin to make their way down the distillation tube. The vapor that is in the coil is cooled by the flowing cold water that surrounds it. The vapor then condenses and turns back into liquid water and is collected in a beaker at the end. After one distillation, the river water should already be pure and safe enough to drink. However, we'll do another distillation just to be safe. In order to determine the change in quality, we have chosen to take three different measurements: pH value, volume in milliliters, and conductivity. In nature, you don't want to take any risks. That's why we will be distilling the water again. Here we are pouring the first distillation back into the boiling flask. Now we ignite the gas with the sparker and adjust the Bunsen burner in order for it to get maximum temperature and heat the water at the fastest rate possible. With the water now boiling, the H2O molecules will go through the apparatus again, distilling the water once again. With the first distillation purifying the water quite a bit, a second distillation will simply make sure that we have taken into account all the parasites that might be present in the water. This process, however, takes about 15 minutes and will be shown in time lapse after this short break. In order to test the water for possibly hazardous metals within it, we must undergo the conductivity test. Should the apparatus beep and flash while it is in the water, it is dangerous to drink and might kill you. Evident in this graph is the change in volume throughout the two distillations of water. With each distillation, the amount of water got smaller, as we had waste. Here we have the conductivity measures of the water. As you can see, the river water is a lot more conductive than the distilled water provided in the lap, yet less conductive than the tap water, which is already safe to drink. After only one distillation, the water from the river was already less conductive than the distilled water from the lab, clocking in at a mere 9 microsiemens. After the second distillation, the water was even less conductive, with a value of 6 microsiemens. Here are the pH values that will measure of all the samples of water available. The pH values of 100% pure water would be at 7. The pH value of the river water is the lowest of all the samples at 5.9, meaning it is the most acidic. After one distillation, its pH value shot up to 6.95, which is extremely close to being neutral. Second distillation gave the water a pH of 7.15. In both cases, though, the water had a closer pH to 7 than the distilled water provided in the lab. The goal of this investigation was to discover a way to purify the river water so that it would be safe to drink. In this regard, we have succeeded. The distillery we were able to set up using equipment from the lab, we were able to purify water with ease. Based on the data, it is safe to say that distilling water twice is not effective. River water was already safe to drink after the first distillation, and there wasn't a significant difference between the water once distilled and the water that was twice distilled.
And the fluid in this, again, is drinkable. Drinkable, but truly disgusting.